And we welcome you back to the second hour now of WCW Saturday Night. In the second hour, the Steiners in our main event against the amazing French Canadians. Ming will be here, plus Jeff Jarrett, and a look back at Nitro when Ric Flair brutally attacked at the hands of the New World Order in his match against Six, plus Eric Bischoff and Sting have a, I guess, little confrontation, so to speak, in the ring. Many of you saw that on Nitro. Those of you who did not will be entertained, I'm sure. But there's more to that. Before we talk about that, let's talk about this. Nitro returns to its regular starting time, 7:55 p.m. and live, 2 hours this coming Monday from Nashville, Tennessee. Nitro is back at its regular starting time. We can't wait to get to Nashville. Now, for those of you who did not see or did see Nitro this past Monday, when we went off the air, Sting and Eric were still in the ring. A lot more happened, and we'll show you the never-before-seen footage later in this telecast. Plus, Dream, Diamond Dallas is here. You know he's got a lot to say. As Scotty Riggs makes his way in, I think what makes this, one of the things that makes the Diamond Dallas Page Macho Man rematch, Page 2, no disqualification, so intriguing, is the fact they are very similar, as you said.
Yeah.
They are not afraid of each other.
No.
And that makes for a great match.
Yeah, the Macho Man Randy Savage has been on top of his game for a long time. And you see the Squire, or Dave Taylor, if you will, really going ahead and taking Scotty Riggs to task really early right here, early on Saturday night. Yeah, but Dallas came along, had to really achieve a lot just through pure hard work and getting beat up and staying at it. But I guarantee in the finished product is what we'll be looking at the Great American Bash, mirror images of each other. One of them really wanted to rule the 90s, you know what I mean? Can Savage, does he still have enough in him to do that? Yes, he does. Can Dallas Page step it up a notch? Savage, Page 2, only on pay-per-view, the Great American Bash, Moline, Illinois, coming up. I mean, we already had a big, exciting hour, the first one. Now we're getting into it here.
And you know, in the wars that have developed over the last year between the NWO and WCW, this is NWO, WCW, Page against Savage, but it has transcended that. It has become personal between two men. It started with the attacks.
In the magazines,
yeah. And the talk about Kimberly.
Yeah.
And then when Dallas, not only did he nail everybody with that crutch, as you talked about, at Slamboree, but then when Dallas tells Savage that he is just no more than a follower of Hollywood Hulk Hogan,
really
got Savage angry.
Yeah, but you know, sometimes you gotta call it like you see it.
That's what it is.
Yeah, and Hollywood rule, you said it earlier, he's the world's heavyweight champion. He is the NWO, and the rest of these guys have to really be on top of their toes now because they're in a little hurting situation. Yeah, they did stumble mud hole in the Nature Boy Ric Flair, but Sting coming up out of nowhere and grabbing a hold of Eric Bischoff, and the footage that was not seen being seen on Saturday night. Oh man, everything is going down. But before Dallas came back strong on the Macho Man, Hogan, here we go. We just said it. Hogan and Macho beat him nearly half on the way down. You know what I mean?
I know what you're saying.
Beat him with an inch of it and really got on top of him. And yeah, Kimberly laid that NWO sprayed on him. Let's go way back and talk about it. Yeah, I believe it's egos. I believe it's a man that knows that he wants the spot that the Macho Man Randy Savage has, and the Macho Man wants to save that spot. Savage, Page 2. Page 2.
And how about this?
Riggs, Page 1, trying to get through the pay window. Still on Saturday night.
Oh my goodness, David Taylor says, forget about it, I'm taking you back down.
Yes.
And he did hard.
You know what I mean? It made him mad down there.
Sure did.
Riggs was a beating on him, and he just jumped up and said, well, this is the way it can happen to you very easily. Now back, going back at his business at hand, taking care of his business.
So much animosity, so much on the mind of DDP and of the Macho Man Randy Savage. We do understand that when Diamond Dallas joins us later on in this telecast, he wants to conduct the interview by himself.
Well,
he says he needs no one.
Nobody. Ain't nobody helped him on the way up, so
That's right.
What I mean? He's here. Let him do his thing. And another thing, Tony, you know who impressed me at Slamboree? Kevin Green. Mongo and Green both impressed me. Well, I'm going to tell you what. Mongo learned his trade, but Kevin Green, from football right into the frying pan. But you know what? When you associate yourself with the Pipers and the Flares, it's got to rub off.
Yeah.
Got to rub off.
Not only that, Kevin Green proved on Monday when he attacked Mongo that he did not forget what happened to the Great American Bash
not.
A year before.
Exactly. Exactly. That's
as announcers, we kind of like shoved that under,
yeah, but
under the
they did. He did. No, he probably was thinking about it when he was out there playing in the big bowl game.
That's right.
I mean, he was probably thinking about getting hit on the noggin.
That's right.
And that's true. But there, things like that happen. Some of it lingers longer with people. Other people forget. You know. And we've seen Regal tonight holding up the four fingers.
Four times world television champ.
Or was it? Well, four? I won't even say it. Is that new? Do I have my own highlight? No, I don't.
Four times world television champ.
Yes, it is. But he held it in a full, fashionable way.
How about this? Good maneuver by Dave Taylor that time. He had that hold and made it a suplex. That's incredible.
Yeah, and he's back on that ankle. And that will break an ankle right here. More than uncle you, you'll have to walk around on crutches.
Just ask Randy Savage.
And yeah. And ask DDP.
That's right. European uppercuts. Now listen to these. He is laying these in. I mean, he is hitting there. Listen. Oh, my goodness.
You know what? He really ragged this guy.
Yes.
Scotty Riggs. Scotty Riggs came in a drop kicking and a flying around there. Oh, man. Dave Taylor laid that one in. Nearly took his chest off.
And that's the thing about a European uppercut. Yes, it hits the jaw and rocks the head back, but it also pounds on the chest, can knock the breath right out of you as well. That's why they're so effective. And
running
there's
good.
A forearm shot on the top of the head, then a cover, and he wins it.
Yeah, nice move.
That was a great win out of that. And we'll be back on Saturday night.